So in the previous two video parts, we have seen the classification and the nomenclature and the component naming, and then we have also seen the working of SI engine and CI engine, and some important points I have already discussed which are useful for interviews also. Now we'll apply the first law of thermodynamics, that is the energy balance simply. So this dotted line shows the control volume, which is the engine, inside of the engine. So what are we inputting is the energy in the fuel. So we are giving the fuel, and that contains energy. And then there are three levels of laws. So there are two levels of laws actually. First is the energy loss because of exhaust, coolant and radiation, that is the actual mass with a high temperature mass which is going out of our control volume, and it is carrying the energy with itself. And there is the second, minor losses, which are friction loss, pumping loss and some unaccounted losses. So this is the indicated energy available. And after first loss, then there is some lesser amount of energy which is available. So over here, this is the total energy in fuel, and a part of it is used, which is the indicated energy which is available. And BP means the brake power. This is the indicated power, and this is the brake power, which is the actual energy used. So we can see that this is the total energy after the major losses, which are the energy losses in exhaust and coolant radiation. Only the indicated energy is available. So this is the first level of loss, this is the second level of loss. So after first level of loss, only indicated power is left, and after second level of minor losses in energy because of friction, only brake power BP is available. Hence we can define thermal efficiency or efficiency of our engine in many different ways. So this is the first way, which is the indicated thermal efficiency, and eta, which is IP, which is the indicated power divided by the total energy available in fuel. Eta BTH means the brake thermal energy efficiency, which is BP divided by E. And mechanical efficiency, eta M, is BP by IP. So eta M would be generally 60 to 80%, and while this will be, so the eta ITH will be larger than eta BTH because BP is smaller than IP, and this would be around 30, 40, 50%, and this will be around some 5, 10% slower. And there are a list of engine parameters which will evaluate the performance of our engine. So the basic ones are indicated thermal efficiency, represented by this, which I explained earlier. Then it is brake thermal efficiency, eta BTH, which I explained earlier. Then it is mechanical energy, which is eta M, which I explained earlier. And this eta M can also be evaluated by the ratio of eta BTH by eta ITH, because the denominator is common, hence the formula. Then there is volumetric efficiency, indicated by eta subscript V. Relative efficiency or mechanical efficiency ratio, given by eta REL relative. Mean effective pressure, there are many, two or three mean effective pressures which are defined, we'll see them. They are defined as per indicated power and brake power differently. Then there is mean piston speed, which is SP bar, mean piston speed. And then there is specific fuel consumption, SFC. And then we have air fuel ratio, which is P by A, F by A or A by F. So you need to be very critically reading this. It should be fuel air ratio or air fuel ratio, because you may get confused while solving problem, and that is a huge confusion. So generally the fuel air ratio goes around 1:15, or air fuel ratio will go 15:1. So read that critically. And also, while using the formulas which I will describe later, please be very much sensitive to the units which you are using. So whatever power which are being specified, use them in kilowatts. Whatever pressure you are specifying, use them in newton per meter square or bar or atm, but be consistent with units. Length and area in meter and meter square, speed in rpm or radians per second as per the need. N is the number of power strokes. So for a four stroke engine, the relation between small n and capital N is small n is equal to capital N divided by 2, and for two stroke engine, small n and capital N are equal, and K is the number of cylinders. So let's do this again. So indicated thermal efficiency is indicated power divided by the total energy available in fuel. So this is in watts, and this should be in watts. So energy in fuel per second. So whatever fuel flow rate we are using, it should be used here. Hence, this is indicated power divided by the calorific value of fuel divided into the mass flow rate. So wherever the energy per second comes, we can use this calorific value of fuel into the mass flow rate. Mass of fuel per second is the mass flow rate of fuel, which will be calculated using this carburetor, which I have shown earlier. Then similarly, the eta BTH, that is brake thermal efficiency, will be BP divided by the energy in fuel, and energy in fuel can be again changed with this calorific value of fuel and mass of fuel per second. So mass of fuel will be kg per second, and calorific value will be kilojoules. Here eta M, that is the mechanical efficiency, will be BP by IP, and earlier we have seen that what is the difference between BP and IP is the friction loss, frictional power which is lost. So IP makes BP plus frictional loss, BP divided by BP plus frictional power. So frictional power will be IP minus BP. Then there is a formula for the efficiency, volumetric efficiency, eta subscript V. So it is been described as mass flow rate of air divided by the density of air into displacement volume into capital N divided by 2, or we can also define by eta V m dot A. Eta V is equal to m dot A upon rho A into displacement, this is the volume of the D. So this is the displacement volume D. Okay, so what is the displacement volume? Let me show that again. So this is the displacement volume. Whatever piston displaces, the stroke length multiplied by the bore area. This is the stroke length, and multiplied by the bore area gives the displacement volume. And the net thermal efficiency is described by actual thermal efficiency divided by the air standard efficiency. So actual thermal efficiency will be calculated using this cycle, which is the actual fuel air cycle, whatever it may be, petrol engine or diesel engine, but that will be the as per the actual cycle. And for a standard Carnot cycle, whatever air fuel efficiency we are getting, air standard efficiency, will use here to find N relative. Then we can indicate the indicated power in terms of the pressure into volume, because pressure into volume will also give the units of energy, and that divided by some seconds or some flow rate will give the power. So we have defined indicated power using P into V or P into V dot, and then we have rearranged this to find the indicated mean effective pressure. So this here mean effective pressure is being used here. So this is the mean effective pressure. This is indicated power 60,000 upon L length, area meter square, n number of cycles, so the number of power strokes, and K is the number of cylinders, and IP must be in kilowatts here, and the unit curvature is already been applied, that is 60,000 has come because of that. And this stroke, the number of strokes and number of cycle relation has been already applied. The division by 60 is already taken place. So please use number of power strokes. Number of power strokes also means number of cycles. Number of cycles and the conversion from number of cycle to the speed will have 60, because this is defined as per minute. So to convert to per second, we have divided by 16 there. And also the PIM is defined as area of indicator diagram, that is the cycle which we have shown, PV diagram, that is the area of the PV diagram divided by the length of the indicator diagram. The length of the indicator diagram is this much, that is the displacement volume and the area. So that ratio also gives the mean effective pressure, indicated mean effective pressure. So this formula has been used to solve one of the problem in the textbook also. Then there is brake mean effective pressure also defined. So this is defined very much similar to this. Here we have changed from IP to BP, that's all. Then we had mean piston speed. So mean piston speed is been defined like this: 2 into stroke length into the number of strokes, speed in revolution per minute. So please use per minute also. So this will give meters per minute. The units will be meters per minute, so you need to convert for meters per second. And if they are in radians, number of revolutions, so please convert to number of radians also. Please convert to radians. So radians are ignored in unit, so convert n to radians per second and then use in here to get meters per second. This is specific fuel consumption. So that is fuel consumption per unit time divided by power. So this fuel consumption will come from the carburetor flow rate, and then we divide it by the indicated power will give indicated specific fuel consumption. And if we divide it by the brake power, we'll get brake specific fuel consumption, and then specific power output. So it has been also defined by two things with respect to indicated power and brake power. Generally we use brake power here. So it is brake power divided by the area, and by doing mathematical manipulations we can get it to be some constant into PBM into mean piston speed, but this is not used mostly. We need only this formula. Okay. Thank you.